It's the morning of August 26, 2023, at the Denver and Rio Grande Western's iconic depot in Durango, Colorado. K-36 Mikado number 482 parts the roundhouse to tie onto its train. K-482 backs down onto its train at the depot. My visit to Durango and Silverton, as well as various other destinations in and around the state of Colorado, was spurred on by my attendance of the 2023 National Narrow Gauge Convention being held in Denver. At the convention, I would be displaying a modular HON3 narrow gauge model railroad based off of Malcolm Furlow's San Juan Central. The weekend prior to the convention was spent on the Durango and Silverton, taking the regular train to Silverton Saturday, and a special charter trip for the convention Sunday. At 8:15 a.m. exactly, 482 heads train 461, the first Silverton of the day, out of Durango. A short while later, K-36 number 480 also leaves the roundhouse to tie on to the second train departing for Silverton. At 9 a.m. exactly, 480 on the head of train 463 departs Durango for Silverton. Nearing the outskirts of town, we make our first crossing of the Animas River. After leaving the Durango metropolitan area, we pick up speed as we traverse the flatlands between Trimble and Hermosa. At the end of the valley, you pass through the one-time station and water stop of Hermosa. The grade begins in earnest just past the road crossing, and 480 puts on a great show as we climb the 2.5% grade to Rockwood. At Rockwood, train 463 makes a stop to take on more passengers before entering the Animas River Canyon. As we pass the Forest Service sign for the San Juan National Forest, we are nearing the most iconic part of the Durango and Silverton route, the High Line. pass the High Line, number 480 and train cross another iconic scene on the Silverton branch, the second crossing of the Animas River on a combination wood and steel trestle. Train 463 passes through Tacoma. Further up the line at Tank Creek, number 480 stops to take on water. Continuing up the line, the scenery becomes truly impressive and dramatic as we make our way towards Silverton. Here in Silverton, we make one last crossing of the Animas River before entering town. Upon arrival in Silverton, passengers are given approximately an hour and a half to grab lunch in town. After doing so, I walked around town and explored the old depot and rail yards, as well as photographed the switching of the two trains prior to their departures back to Durango. After turning on the Y, 480 and train back into the depot to load passengers for the return trip to Durango. With time to spare ahead of train 462's departure, I made a trip to the 315 Historical Society's small museum close to the old depot and took a good look at the equipment on display underneath the train shed. I also took the time to explore the original depot at Silverton ahead of train 462's departure from town. Right on schedule, number 482 and train passed the original Silverton Depot on their way back down the hill to Durango. After 462's departure and a brisk walk back to the passenger loading area, I reboard the train for the trip back down the branch to Durango. On the outskirts of town, we pass a long abandoned minehead, ripe with modeling potential, before crossing the Animas River for the first time on the downhill run. As rain begins to fall, it becomes abundantly clear that high in the Rockies, weather can take a turn within minutes. The 480 and train pass a long realigned section of right-of-way, including an old through truss bridge. Train 464 passes historic Needleton Tank. Further down the line, we round the sweeping curve at Goblin Fire. This will be the future location of one of the runbys on the charter train the following day. Performs a blowdown as we cross the Animas River ahead of the High Line. As we again cross the High Line, our train is bathed in the afternoon sun. We again pull into Rockwood to let off the passengers we picked up there in the morning. now at the bottom of the grade, 480 in train pickup speed as we pass through Hermosa. In another example of unpredictable weather in the Rockies, torrential downpours would come down hard on us as we neared Durango. Upon our arrival back in Durango, we see K-28 number 473 idling on the head of the Blues train awaiting its departure later in the afternoon. The evidence of the torrential downpours is clear by the large puddles on the ground. I was up early the next morning, well ahead of the 7:30 a.m. departure of the Silverton Mixed. In the meantime, I took photos of various pieces of equipment in and around the depot area, including our mixed train's consist as well as RGS Goose Number 5. Number 473 and an ex-Uinta Railway water car depart the roundhouse ahead of tying on to their train. As 473 idled at the depot, I took the time to photograph the locomotive, its running gear, and various other aspects that make the K-28 so unique. Shortly before our departure, I boarded the caboose and we set off for Silverton. Once again, we pull into Rockwood to pick up more passengers for the run to Silverton, many of whom chase the train up from Durango. Once on the High Line, 473 and train stop to let off passengers and backs up for the first run-by of the day, as well as the only run-by on the trip up to Silverton, as we were less than 45 minutes ahead of the regularly scheduled passenger trains. Handled by Mike May at the throttle, puts on a good show as she traverses the High Line. Following the run-by, Rio Grande Southern Galloping Goose No. 5 pulls in behind us, having followed us up from Durango. That is a The previous day's rains kicked up a good amount of silt, and the Animus River was this reddish-brown color as far as Needleton. Get a brief glimpse of the former powerhouse as 473 in the mix passed through the siding of Tacoma. While hanging off the side of a caboose might seem precarious, it really does lead to some great shots of the train as it winds its way up the Animus River Canyon. Again, at Tank Creek, 473 stops to take on water. Upon our arrival in Silverton, we get to experience some rare mileage as we remain on board the train as it turns on the Y. Upon our arrival into Silverton, we see train 461 from Durango pull into the station. With its passengers unloaded, train 461 reverses out of the station to turn on the Y. As the Silverton Mix idled in the passenger loading area, I took the opportunity to photograph the train as well as 473 prior to the arrival of train 463 from Durango. With both regular passenger trains arrived, Silverton Mix departs town passing the original depot. few miles down the line, at a location known as Elk Park, we again offload in preparation for the second run-by of the day. Normally, photo freight trains would keep their consists together for the entire run. However, the Silverton Mixed today had two flat cars loaded with ties that we would be setting out at the Elk Park Y for the maintenance of way crews for a replacement project between Elk Park and Silverton. This gave us a rare opportunity to witness a steam locomotive perform switching tasks that serve a practical purpose other than for pure photography. We also got the opportunity to witness the long tradition of hand signals employed by railroad employees for almost two centuries at this point. Thank you. Once again, the weather begins to turn as we make our way down the Animas River Canyon. At Goblin Fire, we once again disembarked the train for two photo run-bys, the first of which was on the fireman side of the tracks and featured 473 running over two torpedoes, which are explosive devices meant to warn train crews about oncoming maintenance or otherwise obstruction of the track ahead. For the second run-by, as well as the last run-by of the trip, we move over to the engineer's side of the tracks. Once again, we crossed the High Line with 473 and train basking in the afternoon sunlight. With our final crossing of the Animas River, we arrived back in Durango, thus completing a weekend on the Durango and Silverton Narrow Gauge Railroad. With our arrival back in Durango, it was time to explore the Roundhouse Museum, featuring an HO and HON 3 gauge display layout sponsored in part by nearby Soundtracks. With its passengers unloaded, 473 and train round the balloon loop to perform switching as well as clear the platforms for the two trains from Silverton. The museum is also home to various displays of both full-size and miniature equipment, including K-28 number 478, along with several other displays of various model railroad scales, ranging from HON3, HO, ON30, to G, and even Lego. As 480 and train arrive at the Durango Depot, this concludes my trip to the Durango and Silverton Narrow Gauge Railroad ahead of the 2023 National Narrow Gauge Convention in Denver. The next day, I would be off to Denver for the convention, and that will be covered in subsequent videos along with the layout I displayed at the convention. Stay tuned for those, and thank you all for watching.